In 26 AD, a Roman aristocrat named Pontius Pilate arrives in the Mediterranean port of Caesarea to take control of the region.
On arrival in the province, Pilate would have made his headquarters in Caesarea. This was going to be the Roman base, as it had been for all the other prefects before him. This is a replica of a stone that contains our only inscriptional evidence for Pontius Pilate. It was found here at Caesarea in 1961, and what's really interesting about it is that here is Antius Pilatus, which is clearly a reference to Pontius Pilate.
The stone also tells us that Sejanus wanted a strong man to keep the troublesome Judeans in check.
This word here, prefectus, this shows that Pilate's title was actually prefect, which is a military title. It suggests that Pilate's main role here in the province was to maintain law and order, to make sure that there was no riots or rebellions, that national security was maintained at all times.
And although the Gospels portray Pilate as a reasonable man, historical records paint quite a different picture of Sejanus' man in Judea.
The kind of information that we have in Philo of Alexandria or Josephus about Pontius Pilate show him as a pretty cruel and ghastly man.
His governorship was a list of atrocities, including executions of prisoners without trial. So you get a very different picture of Pilate from these sources compared to what you have in the Gospels.
Pilate's appointment sends a clear message throughout the region. There's a new boss in Rome, and his man won't stand for any trouble.
And this guy is ruthless. This guy is quick to act, and he's violent. Pilate's gonna put down insurrection brutally. He's gonna be sending out a message, a graphic, gruesome warning. Do not cross the Romans.